In our previous lecture, we have discussed the terminologies related to your RDBMS and role of RDBMS and how it is useful in retrieving the data. Just I will revise you people, what is the data, what is the information and what is database. Okay, so that you people will be having the clarity for the classes. Now, what is the data? Data is nothing but a collection of raw facts. Raw facts means what, ma? It can be anything like text, numbers, images, and etc. That is nothing but your data. Means to say, collection of raw facts are called as data. For example, if I am having a collection of words like this, I going am to college. This is a collection of data. Why? Because it is not giving any meaning. Why? It is a collection of raw facts. Collection of words, I can say. This is a data. But when I am processing that data, if I am doing something onto this particular collection of words, and if I am converting that into the sentences, then that will become your information. Okay? See this, how we will convert this data into your information. Say suppose if I am performing operational onto this, and if I am converting this into I am going to college, then it is giving some meaning. So when we are processing the data, in turn it will give us the information. That is the reason we are saying that information is nothing but the collection of processed data, we are saying. Okay, and when we are going for the database is nothing but what? Collection of interrelated data. What do you mean by collection of interrelated data? Say, consider if you are taking a student database, then you people will be having the information which is related to student, like student number, student name, student ID, student marks, student grade, everything which is related to your student. That is the reason we are calling that as a database. Okay, these are the few things that you need to remember before going for the further classes. And you need to remember about the database management system. Already I told you people, it is a collection of programs, or it is a software that will be handling your databases. Handling means what? It will be creating, it will be defining, it will be manipulating, updating, inserting, whatever the operation that you want to perform onto the databases. If you want to create the databases, then you people will be taking the help of database management system. Okay. Now in today's session, we are going to cover a topic called functions of database management system. In this, you see, it will be covering so many important functions for you people in order to give the accurate data, or as appropriate data should be reached to what? Users. In order to happen that, it is having so many functionalities that will be guaranteeing you people that we will be providing the integrated and constant, or as a consistent data to you people, I can say. Okay, and see, the data will be very transparent when we are using the database management system, but every person will not be having the database management system knowledge now. For that reason, end user will always ask the details, end user will always request the details as per their knowledge, but we will be using the DBMS in order to work with that particular data. Okay, functions will be transparent to the users, they know the functions, but how do we use them? Where do we store the data? That details will be hidden from your users. And by using the DBMS, we will be achieving that. We will be making a function. We will be creating a communication between the end user, application programs, or your databases, I can say. Okay. In this way, we will be creating a session. And whatever the things that I have written over here, data dictionary, data storage management, data transformation and presentation, security management, multi-user access control, backup and recovery, management and data integrity management, everything will fall under the functionalities of your DBMS. I hope it is clear. Alright, now we will discuss few of the functionalities in detail. Okay, now the first function that we are going to discuss is your data dictionary management. What the dictionary will contain? Data about that data, I can say. Alright, say consider if you are storing lot amount of data into your databases, those data will be having some relations right? Then when you are using the data dictionary management, it won't allow you people, it won't ask you people to create a complex program so that you people can remember the relation between the data. So in order to not happen that, we will be using the data dictionary so that it will be storing the information about the relation between the data and it will be handling the data about the data, right? Where we are storing from, where we are retrieving that, it will be stored from your data dictionary management, okay? And the relationship among the data will be given by the data dictionary itself, okay? And see, it will be eliminating the structural data dependencies. Say suppose as we are having the relation between the data, so whatever the application that you want to use, you can use at the end side. There will be not having any restrictions. You can use any application, you can use any interface to communicate, but the data dictionary will be managing the relationship so that it will be retrieving the data and it will be providing the data for users. Okay, that is what the major point is. In turn, it removes the necessity updating of each program. Means to say that every program will not be changed. Okay, so consider that if you are changing the structure and the physical layer, then it won't be reflected onto the application layer. Okay, so that application structure can be changed, but automatically according to that your data dictionary will change its structure. So that you need not to change anything manually by coming to the physical structure. Okay, so that will be reflected onto your data dictionary management. That will be taking the responsibility, I can say, in order to not happen that, in order to not give that much of overhead for your operating style, I can say. Okay, so this is what your data dictionary management is. Means to say that it will be storing the data about the data and it will be maintaining the relation among the data. So it won't allow you people to create a complex data structure that stores the relation among the databases. Okay, so it will be eliminating the data dependency, means structural dependency, I can say. Okay, if you are changing any structure at the physical layer or some layer, if you are changing anything, that will be automatically reflected onto your data dictionary map. Okay, so that is why we are using a function called data dictionary management. And the next one is data storage management. So this is one where we will be actually storing the data. Means to say that we are physically storing the data somewhere. We will be using some devices to handle that. In order to do so, what we are doing is we are using data storage management service, or as the function, I can say. It will create a complex data structure in which you want to store your data. Physical structure will be created in order to store the data. Means to say that if you want to have this kind of table, if you want to store some data onto the physical devices, then you people will be creating some structure in which you want to store your data. That will be done by your storage management, and it avoids defined organized physical data characteristics. Means to say that it won't allow you people to fix the characteristics. If you want to change the structure at the physical layer, it won't affect your logical structure. Okay, so that it will be very, very, very helpful in order to manage the data. Why? Because every time application programmers will not update their structure. Every time physical structure will not be updated. Why? Because you will be having a lot of issues when we are storing the data, right? Defining the data structure, storing the data into the data structure and updating it and deleting it. Everything will not be happening at the same time. So physical structure will be maintained by your storage manager. And the second one that I would say for you people is, when we are seeing it the user's perspective, means to say that the end user who is not having any knowledge, those who are using the databases, they will be not having any information about physical structure, where they are storing from, where we are retrieving the information. So they will be having a logical thinking that somewhere I have stored my data, from that I am picking it. But it is not true. We will be storing the data in different systems, I can say, at the different servers, at multiple sites. But still, logical view of the user will be that, okay, data stored at somewhere and from that only I am picking it. Okay, but in the same way, we will be serving the end user. Okay, we will be not having any issues with the end user. If you want to think like that, you can think somewhere we have stored and we will be retrieving the data from that particular place and we will be available we will be make available for that particular data for you people, I can say, by using what? Your function called data storage management. It can access the data. It can access the data through your DBMS if it stores in different multiple locations also. That is not a big deal. Okay, by using what? DBMS. Okay, and the next one is data transformation and data presentation. See ma'am, we will be having number of users. We'll be having number of users, those who will be using the data in different ways. The function is used for transforming the data in such a way that it is conformed to required data structure. Means to say that I want to receive the data in this particular format only, if you want to say. Then you can do by using what? Database management system. The transformation should be conformed so that it will be given in that particular physical structure. Okay. And the second one is presentation. See, if I am using a mobile device, if I am using a laptop, if I am using a desktop, if I am using a big screen, there will be appearance difference. Okay, the content will be the same one, but the appearance will be different from one device to other device. The presentation should also play a key role when they are receiving the data. If they want to receive it in a small device, they should receive. If they want to receive it in a big device, they can receive. If you are using appropriate database management system, if it is not available, if it is not done, then we can say we are not using a proper database management system. It provides a clear distinction between what? Physical data format and logical data format. Physically, you can store it in any structure, but end user will be using the browser, right? In their mobile devices, in their laptops, in their desktop. In which they want to present the data, you need to present them in that particular way. That is what the main mode of this particular function. Okay, these are the three important functions that you need to observe in your database management system. See, in our today's session, we have seen three kind of functions that are available by your database management system. One is data dictionary management, second one is data storage management, and data transformation and presentation. The remaining functions that I will be discussing in the next lecture. I hope it is clear to you people, and remaining things will be discussed in next session. That's it for now. See you in the next one. Thank you.